Come for that beer after all, eh? Here, sit down. Get a pint in her hand. Wasn't expecting you to swing by.
Since when do I do what's expected?
Ha! There's that spark. Fire and spit.
Fire and spit.
That's a blast from the bellows. Won't fix the forge, but at least I can forget about my troubles for a while.
Like what?
Take your pick. We got bodies to bury from the Bristlebacks, the work stoppage, Olvin grating the gears about his concession decree. Hey! Weapons off the table! Ah, don't listen to me. Nothing a cold brew and knocking some heads together can't fix eventually.
So about Olvind?
Around here, everything's about Olvind.
How'd he end up in charge?
He got here early, like a squirrel smelling a fat nut. He knew rebuilding Baron Light would need stone and timber. So he jangled purses all over Mainspring, getting investors to front claims on anything in the Daunt that might be worth a damn. Thing is, all the bankers back home know that this is Karja land, and the Sun King can revoke those claims at any time. That's why he's desperate for the magistrate to sign off on a concession decree.
This concession decree, what is it exactly? And how would it help Olvind?
It's pig diddle, that's what.
A writ that would put all Osram claims in the Daunt under Osram law, even though they're on Karja land. It would mean that any existing ore, stone, and timber claims couldn't be revoked by the Karja. No more risk, no more hesitation for investors back in the claim to pour in the shards and expand their business. And since Olvind has a stake in all those claims, it would make him richer than a scrapper in a junk heap. Not to mention Chainscrape would become an Osram municipality, so he could buy enough votes to call himself an Elderman. He's a sly old badger, I'll give him that. Figures if he keeps up the pressure, eventually the magistrate will sign.
So the Bristlebacks in the Daunt. Where did they come from?
That's the thing. No one rightly knows. They just showed up one day, rampaging around the valley like they exploded out of a forge. Lost some good people. But bless the bellows, you cleared them out and got this place working again. That put a dent in Olvin's plans. Now, if only there were some way to smash them all together and run them out of town.
But how could Bristlebacks and the Daunt help Olvind?
Two words. Concession decree. Since no one knows where the Bristlebacks came from, Olvind has taken to blaming the Karja for him. He's hoping to dig up enough old resentments to get a strike going until the concession's signed. This is just his latest attempt. He's been trying to rile up the workers since the day he rolled into town.
And people actually believe him?
Lots of folks suffered at the hands of the Mad King during the Red Raids. Give him half a reason, they'll blame the Karja for anything.
Damn Karja slavers.
Well, I have to be going. Thanks for the drink, Petra. I'm glad I stopped by.
Anytime, Flamehair.
Savior, thank you for taking the time, and my condolences that you had to endure Olvin's bloviating.
I've dealt with worse. It sounds like he's really trying to put you over the barrel.
The idea that the Karja purposely let Bristlebacks into the Daunt, it's completely absurd. But the louder and longer he says it, the more support he'll get for his damned concession decree.
How did the Bristlebacks get into the Daunt?
No one knows for sure. The first report of them came from west of the quarry. But unless they have wings I don't know about, I don't see how they could have come over the mountains.
No other way in.
The only way I know about is Baron Light. Look, if you can get to the bottom of this, I can offer a considerable bounty in return. Help me shut Ulvind up.
How did you get stuck out here?
I asked for the posting, believe it or not. Overseeing the entire valley on behalf of the Sun King? It was an honor. Is an honor, I mean.
But your job would be a lot easier without someone like Ulvind blasting hot air all the time?
Ulvind's not going anywhere. He's been around longer than I have. Even fancies himself the founder of Chainscrape. Now I'll find a way to live with him. I have to.
What is this concession decree that Ulvind wants?
He wants the Sundom to designate portions of the Daunt as Oseram holdings. Only the portions, mind you, that produce any value.
Let me guess, because he stands to profit somehow?
Exactly. With the Daunt under Oseram law, he could secure more investment for their numerous ventures.
He can't get those investments without the concession?
No. Not while there's a chance the Sundom could revoke their access. Hence, why the concession is so important to him. And why blaming the Karja for the Bristlebacks, no matter how absurd, works in his favor.
How does blaming the Karja for the Bristlebacks help Ulvind get his concession?
Look around. This may be the Sundom, but Chainscrape is all gears and rust and bad ale. Claiming that the Karja loosed the Bristlebacks in order to intimidate Oseram laborers into obedience. Well, let's just say no one here has forgotten the atrocities of the mad Sun King. Even with the valley working again, Ulvind hopes he can stir up enough resentment against the Karja to call for a strike.
And if the Oseram refuse to work, unless the concession is signed, you won't have a choice.
Correct. The reconstruction of Baron Light must continue.
You said the Bristlebacks were first spotted west of the quarry?
Yes, according to one terrified laborer, said the ground trembled before they came charging down the hillside. He took off and ran all the way here.
Good place to start looking, then.
If you learn the truth, maybe Ulvind will stop blaming the Karja for every problem under the sun, and maybe then he'll actually focus on rebuilding Baron Light instead.
Hey, Mildef. Mildef. I took some of your stew last time I went into the wilds. Kept me going for a week. Felt like I could have put a strider in a sleeper hold.
Enjoy it while it lasts.
Sounds like you're serving up some impressive provisions here.
Not again. You can have the discount too, but you'll have to come back later.
I think you have me confused with someone else.
Ulvind didn't send you?
No.
Oh, my apologies. It's just that his minions won't stop pestering me. Now I've even worn out my special grip. Since I'm in the midst of a crisis, perhaps you could skip to what it is you wanted?
Some of your food?
Of course.
Are Ulvind's people causing you problems?
Oh, yeah. They constantly demand my best, but the equipment I need to make my signature dishes isn't built for batch cooking. And don't get me started on the Ulvind discount they feel so entitled to.
And if you refuse?
I make meals. No trouble.
Your last customer mentioned your cooking really kept him going out in the wild. Where I'm headed, I could use some of that.
I would be happy to oblige, especially since you have the decency to ask pleasantly.
But?
But my special groove griddle is no more. Without it, I can't cook any of my signature dishes. I hate to think what'll happen when I'm forced to refuse Olvin or his goons. Even if I already had the right ingredients, there's nothing I can do. Unless you can source me a temporary replacement?
What do you need?
For the ingredients. A few pieces of decent wild meat, and I'd say a big handful of bitter leaf stems. That'll do. As for the griddle, a corrugated metal panel might suffice until I can have a new one forged. You'd likely find one in the scrounger pile, if you follow the river to the northeast. Don't worry, I'll clean it first. You'll have no issue finding boars and bitter leaf on your way. Assuming you're as much a hunter-gatherer as your clothing suggests.
Thanks, Smildiff. I'll keep an eye out.
So that's what gratitude sounds like.
And don't let anyone push you around, okay?
If you say so.
Already got enough meat and bitter leaf. Just need to grab a metal panel from the scrounger pile. The way to Baron Light is clear. Get moving.
You're not errant vanguardsman. I will move only when the captain
says...
When
I've cleared out all the bristlebacks, which I have. Captain's orders.
So they're okay?
Banged up, but breathing. And waiting up ahead for you.
But I was supposed to have three escorts.
I'm off to Baron Light, Wadis. Like Aloy said, captain's orders. You can stay here.
Abandoned to the riffraff? I think not.
Guess you're coming with me then. See you there, Aloy.
Well, now that that's done, the embassy can finally get underway. If I can get through it, I'll be able to track down Cylons. Hades. Maybe even a Gaia backup. Guess I could head straight for Baron Light. Or poke around the Daunt some more first.